We're continuing our study of the slope of a line. We've been talking about the slope as the rise over the run, but it also means it's basically the change in the y coordinates that tells you what the rise is over the change in the x coordinates that tells you what the run is. So for instance, if I wanted to find the slope of the line that passes through these two points, I'm actually not going to draw the line. There just seems to be a lot of things getting in the way. But let's see how we would get from one point to the next point. So I could move to the right. Let's see. And that will be my run. How many spaces is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spaces to the right, so that our run is +5. And then we're going to move down 1, 2, 3 spaces to show I'm going down. I'm saying -3. So remember, this is just a number. The slope is simply the number -3/5. That basically tells us the slant of the line going through those ordered pairs. Okay? Basic idea. And by the way, this is not going through 0, 0. I just didn't graph it very accurately. Okay, now what do I mean by the change in y coordinates over the change in x coordinates? Basically, when I'm going from this point, -3, 2, over to the right 5 spaces, that's the difference between the x coordinates. So just take a note. I have an x coordinate and my first ordered pair is 3, and the x coordinate in the second ordered pair is 2. That's 5 spaces away, which is the difference of 2 and -3. So that's how many spaces it is between 2 and -3. Change and difference basically means the same thing. Now, if I look at the y coordinates in red, notice I went down 3 spaces. That's because that's the difference between the height of this coordinate and the height of this other coordinate, right? It's 3 spaces, which is 2 minus -1. It's a basic difference. So this idea, change in y coordinates or change in x over change in x coordinates, is really the same thing as the rise over the run, but we can actually use an algebraic formula for figuring out the slope of the line so that we don't have to always graph the two points and count it that way. As long as the points are close together, it's not so hard counting and you have lots of space to draw a graph, but in general, it's probably easier, you'll see, to go ahead and use this next formula. All right, the slope of the line containing two points, x1, y1, and x2, y2, is given by, and I'm about to give it to you. First, I want to make note, these are just little subscripts, x1 and y1, to show you that, like, that's a different ordered pair than the ordered pair x2, y2. All right, remember it's the change in the y coordinates over the change in the x coordinates. So change basically means difference. So we're going to start off with drawing a fraction bar and a minus sign in both the numerator and the denominator. Now, if I was going to do the change in the y coordinates, basically, let's say I'm trying to get from point 1 to point 2. I could take the y coordinate of point 2 and subtract the y coordinate of point 1. So I'm going to do y2 minus the y1. And then I'm going to do the same thing for the x coordinates. I'm going to take the difference there, so I'm going to do x2 minus x1. So x2 minus x1. This is the most common way you'll see the algebraic formula for slope. But it's important to realize something here. By the way, I wanted to put this x1 in red so you could see which order pair went together. It's also okay to start with a y1 and subtract y2, but if you do that, you also have to do x1 minus x2. So notice the top has the difference in the y values and the bottom has the difference of the x values. But there's something else to really notice here, that in that's just the ordered pair x2, y2 with a y over the x. Remember, you think of the rise over the run, think of y over x. And Here, you're basically seeing the other ordered pair, x1, y1. That's what you're seeing after the minus sign with its y-coordinate over its x-coordinate. But it really doesn't matter which ordered pair you see together over the first, before the minus sign, and which one you see after. So check this out. I could take the first ordered pair right here and put its y over its x, its y-coordinate over its x-coordinate, and then take the second ordered pair and put its y-coordinate over its x-coordinate. Notice by doing this, you still have the change or the difference in the y-coordinates over the change or difference in the x-coordinates. But you have to have the one, each order pair sort of has to go together on top of each other. It's y over its x. All right, let's look at an example. So here's an example. Find the slope of the line passing through 4, negative 6, and 8, negative 3. All right, so here's the setup. You write m equals fraction bar, and a minus sign in both the numerator and the denominator. Now let's take one of the ordered pairs, which it doesn't matter which one you take first and then which one you take second. One's going to go in front of the minus sign, one is going to go after the minus sign. So here's how it works. You don't have to write this down, this is just to help you. So before the minus sign, let's take this ordered pair, 4, negative 6, and put the y-coordinate over the x-coordinate, negative 6 over 4. And then we're going to take the other ordered pair and put its y-coordinate over its x-coordinate, which is negative 3 over 8. And now we simplify the numerator and simplify the denominator. So how do we do negative 6 minus negative 3? Well, that's plus plus. So negative 6 plus 3 will give you negative 3. And 4 minus 8 is negative 4. And then you simplify. Negative 3 over negative 4 is just the number negative 4 thirds. So that's the slope of the line passing through 4, negative 6, and 8, negative 3. Now, what if I had switched and done it the other way? So we sort of start out the same way. But let's say I put the 8, negative 3 first, and then I put the 4, negative 6 second after the minus sign. So before the minus sign, I'm going to put its y-coordinate over its x-coordinate, negative 3 over 8, and for the other ordered pair, I'm going to put its y-coordinate over its x-coordinate, which is negative 6 over 4. And then we simplify. Again, negative 3 minus negative 6, we could do the plus plus. So negative 3 plus 6 is 3, and 8 minus 4 is 4. Oh, by the way, this was positive 3/4, right? And negative divided by negative is positive, so I don't even need to write the sign. And so I did get the same answer. Hey, it's good I did a little check there. I might have had the wrong answer. The last thing you can do is get a little picture of where these two points are. And you can actually count the spaces, or you can just get an idea to see if it seems reasonable 3/4 is the slope. So I'm just going to approximate. Where's 4, negative 6? Well, over 4 and down 6. I don't know, maybe it's somewhere like that. And then where's 8, negative 3? It's further to the right and down not as far. And if I were to graph that, I can see that it's slanting in the positive upward direction, so it should be a positive slope. So 3/4 seems reasonable. If you want, you could actually plot those points exactly and do the rise over the run. And when you simplify it, you would also get a slope of 3/4. So here's a graph of these two points. I put them in red dots. Here's 4, negative 6. Here's 8, negative 3. This is being very exact. And if I was going to just do the rise over the run, I would say, well, I'm going to the right 4 spaces. And then I'm going up 3 spaces, And so I get a slope of 3/4, and that's what we also got by using the formula. So I have a lot more examples on the next video. What you do have to be careful of is that you have to put the minus sign in carefully, and you have to remember to put the y value over the x value for one order pair before the minus sign, and the next order pair, the y value over the x value.